here, Dhyanastava, it retires a poem which is related to meditation. So, this is 10th, 11th century Acharya Bhaskaranandi, and prominently was Digambara Acharya. And previously I discussed three types of meditation. So two types of meditation, which are like Artan Rodra Dhyan, which is avoidable. Artha Dhyan means one is in under the distress, under the negative emotion. Similarly, Rodra Dhyan is also negative emotion. But Dharmadhyana is auspicious meditation, positive meditation, and it is related to lot more swadhyay, thinking, concentration, contemplation, and like disposition. So all are related to the Dharmadhyana. And then I discussed the four types of Dharmadhyana. So Ajna Vijay, one who follow the teachings of the Tirthankara, and that is falling under the Ajna Vijay. Apai Vijay, one who think about the bad consequences of karma, and that is Apai Vijay. Vipak Vijay, bad result of karma, because karma sometime giving good result, and that is Sukh Vipak. And the karma giving bad result, that is Dukh Vipak. So that condition is really very, very important to know. Otherwise, we so much disturbed and perturbed. Oh, why this happened to me? So for that reason, Apar Vichay meditation is important to know. And then Vipak Vichay. Vipak Vichay, Agya Vichay, Apai Vichay, Vipak Vichay, then Sansthan Vichay. The fourth type of meditation is Sansthan Vichay. And Sansthan Vichay meditation is very important, because where we are. If you don't know the maps, previously in your car always a big map book. And nowadays you have TomTom or something which is guiding you, okay, take turn, go ahead, move there. So that is, again, at your mobile, when you walk through the road, you have a mobile guided walk. If you first time coming, like they say, we are coming from Coventry. So now they don't need to call us, Samniji, we are here, how to come, because now it is easy. So map, road map is very, very important for our life. And now, in the field of spirituality, we need a road map. And that road map is our guided meditation. So that road map we can know through the Sansthan Vichay. At present, I am a human being. I am in a human place, that is the middle region of the universe. So what is the below, what is the up, everything is known through the Sansthan Vichay. And then we move a bit further. Okay, meditation is important, and then we are at the concluding the Dharma Dhyana. Sab drishti jnan vrittani moha kshobha vivarjita yas chatmano bhaved bhavo dharma sharma karo hi sah dharma sharma karo hi sah. Sab drishti means right believer. One who has one drishti, and that drishti is the drishti of mithya drishti, means is not right believer. So sometimes what religion does, religion is doing nothing. Why we waste our time? And many modern during the modern time, many people say, Samniji, we don't believe in religion. Okay, what do you believe? We believe in good things. So that is automatic religion. Might you are not giving the name of religion, but you are doing good, it means you are on the right path. So, sadrishti. Sadrishti means one who has right belief. Then, jnan, endowed with knowledge. Because knowledge and darshan, two part of the same coin. Without darshan, there is no knowledge. Without knowledge, there is no darshan. Because they are like a stage of development. First, there is darshan, then jnan. And sometime it could be vice versa, because people don't have faith, but when they listen, when they read, when they discuss, and when they try to find out, okay, what is right, what is not right. So what was not right previously, they delete it, they dissolve it, and then we evolve the new line in their life, and that is right belief. So, three term. Gay means we have to know everything. Then, hey, leave which is not important, which is not right. So, you just like a gardener try to remove the weeds. If weeds are there, then all good things weeds are also eating. So, that the gardener who has right knowledge, then he try to remove the weeds. And then what is the fruit and vegetable and flowers, plant, everything which he want to beautify, the adore the garden. So for that he try to put nourishment, water and nurture more, care more to make a beautiful garden. Similarly our life. So we are our own gardener, and there are some negativity, so we have to stop them. We have to remove them. We have weed out them from our life's garden. So, hey, gay, upade, three important terms. And in the field of meditation, so knowledge and sadhyan and sadhyan is very important. And jnan and dhyan, jnan and darshan are very much connected with each other. And that's why it is important we listen. And when we listen, we know, and then we delete. Okay, this is not right. This is not right as you do housekeeping of your laptop or computer. So you try to remove those files which are not needed, those are duplicated, or those are downloaded by mistake, or those are not necessary now because it is 2018's data and I don't need them. I can need only one master file, but we have to delete all the other version which are not used. So, jnan, sad jnan, right knowledge, right belief, and vrittani, right conduct. The third step comes on the conduct. So, knowledge and faith make your conduct. And then you act accordingly to the right belief and right knowledge. And then moha kshobha vivarjita hai. No more agitated by the deluding karma. Because the main culprit is mohaniya karma. Sometime if you notice, you have time. And if I say, okay, do 10 minutes meditation. But you say, okay, let me do this first, this serial. Okay. Then you started talking on the mobile, on the friend's call, and he's somewhere in overseas. So it might take 30 minutes or 20 minutes. And then someone says, okay, let us go for a movie. Then you move to the movie. And then evening you come, and then again you remember, oh, Samniji told me to do 10 minutes meditation. Oh, I will do. Then your wife called, okay, table is ready. And you sit on the table and then what happened? You don't like that roti. Oh, every day you make sabdi and chapati and paratha, sabji and roti, same thing. I got bored and I don't want to eat. So you leave the food, you went out, take away pizza. Take away pizza and then, so you slowly, you eat enough, then you feel sleepy and you slept. So where my 10 minutes instruction gone? In vain. And how this happened? Most of the thing related to Mohaniya Karma. Otherwise, sitting on the table, okay, no matter. She put her effort. It is Sunday. And no matter, it might be she has no time to make other dishes. And she made simply sabji and roti. No matter. Let me eat now. And then I say, okay, by evening we will bring pizza. Or we will go out to have pizza. Or I will instruct, I know beautiful pizzas. So I will instruct her, make pizzas like this, like this, like this. Add this, add that. So this is again a samyak drishti. A samyak drishti. What is on your plate, on your table, you eat peacefully. And then you suggest. And then you are eligible to say your wife, next time, Saturday, Sunday, no sakroti. Make something different. I will help you. Or read something different. Or have some guidance from the TV serial. Because TV serial, there is so many shapes on the TV. Am I right? So this is one way to take think positively. But a person who is agitated by the moh and kshob, then he became more and then he said, you rubbish, you don't know what was my bad luck, I got married with you. So digging so deep, which is not necessary, and it happens. It is not a story, because I do lot more personal consultation, and then sometime ladies with the tears, my husband threw the plate. My husband said, you cook rubbish. Samaniji, what shall I do? No, you have to change. And still I remember, there was a lady, and our Sajjan Bhai Chopra, she said, my husband is very he took lot more interest in eating nice food. So I always try to make things healthy, but in a different way. The sabji of tarai is very good for health, good for stomach, and being a Marwadi family, Torai sabji is very important for them. So, what we do, I cook torai in 20 ways. I thought, what happened to this lady? 20 ways? But it was Gurudev Chaturmas and it was our gochari. I have seen her 20 ways, means sometime round torai, sometime long torai, sometimes bharva turai, sometimes small turai, sometimes turai with leaves, sometimes turai with other mix. So she said, like, if I have to prepare same thing for a week, then I'm very much aware how to cook, what is the way to make it new, and it is the some combination, some permission, some thing change, and this is the way of life. Because under the sky, on the earth, nothing is new. Nothing is new. All the same ingredients, same vegetables, same things. It is you who can make things new. It is our mind which is creative. If you are creative, you can make your food differently. You can make your life different. Nobody has everything on their plate, on their pocket, in their hand. It is you who can make a big change. So moha kshobha vivarjita, very important. So if things come, if you are a meditator, or you either you jnani or dhyani, then you take things in other way. Okay, smiling. Yes, I will change. Next week I will do something in the weekend. So it is your way of thinking. So bhaved bhavo dharma, then your disposition became, your bhavas are charged with the dharma, and such person indeed causes sharma karo hi sah blessing. Automatically blessing comes to you because you are charged with the positivity. No matter things happen, but happen, take it positive, then life became positive. Anpetam tato dharmat dharmat dhyan mane kadha. So it is already discussed in my previous lecture. What is charged with the dharma, the 10 types of dharma, or that dharma dhyan is multi types. And then very important thing, sama kshamak kshapakayo pra shreni bhyam apramattake. So again here, what is important? Sham means shanti, and kshapak means annihilation of the karma. So in that stage, so here the stage of gunasthan, very important part of dhyan and gunasthan, because dhyan is a way of spiritual development. And what is gunasthan? Gunasthan is also a ladder of spiritual development. So many new faces. So let me explain little bit gunasthan. Do you know what is gunasthan? Anybody? Your new term. Rajibhai is very well acquainted with the gunasthan. So why we discussed gunasthan? So gunasthan is a ladder, and we can check ourselves. We can measure our spiritual progress. Where do I stay? So gunasthan means how much development of your soul, the spiritual ladder, spiritual development ladder. So a ladder is always going ascending, but coming descending also. So ladder has both way. You can ascend on the ladder and you can fall down from the ladder. Mostly people use ladder to go up, but there is no two ladders that okay, you go on and then you need other ladder to come down. There is same ladder. So I would like to, in the context of meditation, little bit discussion of the dharma dhyan and gunasthan. So gunasthan, how many gunasthan? 14 gunasthan, 14 types of gunasthan, or we can say 14 steps of the spiritual development. So mithya drishti gunasthan, the gun means quality, but the other word is mithya drishti. One who is still in the wrong belief, but that person also have some quality, also have some good things, and he take house as a house, cow as a cow, man is a man, woman is a woman. So whatever he understand right, that is right. So that's why it falls under the gunasthan. Mithya drishti, still his belief is wrong. He is not on the right path. So that's why some people, you know, they eat the worldly life, but they never think about the spirituality. They never think about the dharma. They never think the spiritual progress. And if someone wants to do, they say, there is nothing. You should not go. These are false shops. Don't go there. I have seen some people, such people. And time to time, such people come to our contact. Samniji, you are wasting your life. Then I smile. Yes, you know much. Then he say, you know how colorful this world is, how beautiful the life is, how delicious things are. Why don't you go out and see the world in the world's eyes? Behold the world. Samniji, you have wear the different type of colored chasma, so you don't understand the world. Then I say, yes, I might can say you the same thing. You are also colored. So you also have one-pointedness. If you have multi-pointedness, then I don't say, yes, world is colorful, but only world is colorful, the other world is deprived world. I went to University of Texas and I just delivered a lecture. In that lecture, after my lecture, one student asked, yesterday we have seen you in the same dress and today you are again in the same dress. Then I said, yes, I am in Jain nun. So my dress code is always white. And the same dress code lifelong. Oh my God, you doomed with the boredness. Life would be so bored for you because you have no color in your life. Then I say, yes, you can think like this. I spent my 20 years, 18 years in colorful life, and after that, with my own understanding, I adopted this life. And not just jumped, I did 7 years training. I completed my master and bachelor and master degree during my training, and then finally, and still after my 20, at that time nearly 22 or 23 years, but now 32 years, I can say that like I like this color, I love this color, and this is the color, this is the mother color of all colors. And when your viewpoint is changed, then the clothing is not a big matter for you. Food is not a big matter for you. But the precious life and precious years and precious religious activity matters a lot for me. So then I said, I never got bored, and if I get bored, I will inform you. So it is life. So mithya drishti gunasthan. Then there is saswadan samyak drishti gunasthan. And this is, as I talked, it is a ladder. So some goes up, those fall again. So fall again. So the term is very, very interesting. Sa-swadan, swad sahit. There is a little touch of that taste. Suppose you have taken orange juice, and after that, right after, someone asks, oh, how was the taste? Then you say, yes, mix with sour and sweet and this and that, because still you have that feeling on your tongue. Sa-swadan. Because just you kept the glass down. So still that taste on your tongue, on your taste buds. But after a week I ask, okay, what type of that tea? Then you say, Samniji, let me think. Okay, you visited to Bagha Mama or Ram's restaurant. What type of that idli? What type of Lebanese Chinese food? Then you you take some time and you retrieve from your memory. So still you have stored that. So you have that type of taste. And some people say, oh Samniji, when we remember that thing, our mouth is full of water. It means you replayed the whole episode of that test. So here, Saswadan, one jeev, one soul, it developed a bit more, but fallen down from the spirituality. And sometimes nobody knows, the karma comes in the rising state and the jiva fallen down from the spirituality to the worldly life. Many people, there is so, like if we study the personal history of monks and nuns in the Jain tradition, right now I am working on a project of prosopography, that is personal history of monks and nuns. So in that context, we see many people, they came from the worldly life, initiated into monkhood, but after 10 years, 20 years, 30 years, or sometimes 50 years or 60 years, their mind moved and they give up the asceticism and went back to the worldly life. So that is again the rising state of the karma. Mohaniya karma, charitra mohaniya karma, and different type of karma. So Saswadan Gunasthan, a soul fallen down from the upper higher stages and come to the down stage, not touched to the mithyatva Gunasthan, not touched yet, not totally gone to the wrong belief, still a test of the spirituality on its birds, on the test birds. So that condition is Saswadan Gunasthan. Samyag Mithya Drishti. This is again the mixed. So you know, if something mixed wrongly, then it is not right and not wrong. It is not Mithya Drishti and not Samyag Drishti. Not Mithya Drishti, not Samyag Drishti. But in middle, and you know, mixture things have no value or less value, because their mind is not stable. They don't take the right decision doing this or that. Sometimes they move this pole, other pole. So in that moving state, the mind cannot develop in the spirituality. So Misra Gunasthan is not a right Gunasthan. Samyag Mithya Drishti Gunasthan is not a right way, right place to develop oneself. Aviriti samyak drishti gunasthan. Now jeev reached to the samyak drishti. Right belief is there. But the again the one term, avirati, means there is no tyag, no giving up, no pachakhan. In that condition, the spiritual development is not much more. Though the belief is right, he is samyak drishti, but he is not moving fast in the path of spirituality. Then, desh virati sravak gunasthan. Desh virati, you have positivity, you have right belief, but desh virati, all you are sravakas. And sravak is desh virati. Desh virati means in some corner of your mind you have strong belief. Yes, I have to develop, I have to develop, I have to develop. And then you say, you try to do something. Okay, I can't go in the pravachan, let me do one thing. Okay, I can't do samayik, but let me give up one thing every day, because there are lot more eatable, lot more things you can drink, lot more. Okay, let me give up one thing. Out of many, let me give up one thing. So, in that context, it is very important to be a desh virati. And desh virati can develop and he can touch the the height of very high, higher level. And in that higher level, you can develop like anything. Then Pramatta Sanyat Gunasthan, the sixth Gunasthan, Sanyat. Sanyat means Tyagi, means asceticism. So the real like speedy start is there, but still there Pramattata. Pramattata. And Pramattata means like me. I want to develop more, but sometimes some Uday Bhav of karma is there, so I can't develop what is whatever I plan. Might I touch 60%, 70%, 80%, but not 100%. So still Pramattata, some invigilance is there, and that comes and stop me to doing few things fully. So Pramatta Sanyat Gunasthan. And Apramatta Sanyat Gunasthan. Apramatta Sanyat Gunasthan means total vigilance. A person is totally vigilant. And some moment comes in our life, that Apramattata. And in that Apramattata, you are totally on the centered on the soul point. So very, very important. So the sixth and seventh Gunasthan is the appropriate place for Dharmadhyana. Otherwise, Dharmadhyana is not possible in the other type of Gunasthan. Because Mithya Drishti don't move there, and some Saswadan is like very small timing, duration is very small. Then Sammyak Mithya Drishti is moving mind and monkey mind, and then Avirat Sammyak Drishti, the belief is right but acting is not yet started, and then Desh Virati like doing some. So here there is a little bit difference in Digambar and Swetambar. As I mentioned, this today is Digambar, and that's why they lot more try to do in the sixth and seventh Gunasthan. But according to Swetambar views, Dharmadhyana could be in fourth Gunasthan, in fifth Gunasthan. And I can see very important, I have seen one grantha, Mithyatvika Adhyatmik Vikas. So Mithyatvi also, though his whole root is wrong, but he also try to do something, try to develop something. So in that context, he can do some good thing which could be fallen into Dharmadhyana. Om Arham, Om Arham. So here, most of the Dharmadhyana area, I have touched it. And those who still want to come in the Gunasthan class, because in stepping into Jainism, my Friday class, I almost sum up the karma theory, eight karma, ghati karma, aghati karma, and other avarak, vikarak karma. So several things is concluded, and then my next step is moving towards the Gunasthan. And now